Oh, I've gone through a f***ing chair. This is that broken chair.
That's why it's always at the end.
Oh, for f***'s sake. Oh, I've got to fix that f***ing chair, haven't I? Hey? I've gone through a f***ing chair, look. Hiya, folks. We're still both not well. Sharon's got it now, haven't you?
Yes.
You've got your sore throat?
Headache and
sinus all blocked up. But I've recently, well, yesterday, got my sense of smell back. So we thought we'd do this video for you, which one of our kind subscribers, who were they, Sharon?
Herts Hog Melts.
Herts Hog Melts. And their names are?
Julie and Vicky Lee.
Julie and Vicky Lee. They got their own little cottage industry business where they started up to make melts and candle melts and stuff like that, which smell.
Should I read out their letter?
Well, this is the intro bit, baby.
Oh, all right.
Happy Christmas, baby.
Happy New Year.
It's November.
Happy bonfire night.
The reason why I said Christmas is because these would actually make ideal Christmas gifts. And we do like a candle, don't we, baby?
I do like a nice smelly candle. Nice. And I will say, these give off a good aroma. Some candles I've brought, the ones in the glass jars, haven't, the smell's not there, but these, for such tiny little things, give off a
which
good
I could
aroma.
Never smell until today. And I can't believe it. She lit a couple the other day, Sharon, and I couldn't smell them. So here we are. That's why we're doing this video. And we also support the smaller companies. Yeah. I mean, we can all get on the Amazon and contact Blink and Amazon and get a Yankee candle or whatever and spend an absolute fortune. These, in my opinion,
stronger
and from better. A mother and her daughter making these, there's a lot more love goes into it, Sharon. And they're very personalised as well. So, you got a letter from them, baby. Read out the letter.
It says, hi, Martin and Sharon. We're sorry to hear about your lovely dog, Barney. Our dog passed away in May, so we know what painful times it is you're going through. Thank you to take it for so...
Come on, Sharon, put your teeth in.
Thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy lives to review our products. We hand-pour our products from our home in Hertfordshire. Our wax melts are 100% natural and vegan-friendly.
Ooh.
And in there, she's put what she's put in the box for us.
Yeah.
But I must say, I've done two now, two different smells, and it smells lovely.
But we thought we'd bring these to you.
And can I just say, I put this on the fireplace the other day, the one I didn't bother looking, and I've just clocked now that there's glitter also in the candle, which is...
Oh, the melt.
Yeah, in the melt. Look, can you see the glitter?
Yeah, well, she sent us this as well. These are if you don't know what we're talking about when we say melts, folks, these are little burners here. Let me just turn it around so you can see it. I've got to be careful.
Night light inside.
You put a little night light or tea light, as they call them, inside. That heats up the upper tray, and you then put the melts in the top, which we'll show you in a second. They melt down and give off a lovely aroma, and that's what they are. But as I say, these ain't just the melts. They've got a little glitter in it.
Yeah,
I can see it now,
lovely.
Sharon. So let's have a look and see what we got in the box. She sent us a few things. What has she actually sent us?
I am very grateful, I must say. One tea light burner, which is there.
Right, that's the tea light burner.
And two unscented tea lights.
Right, these are, again, if any of you don't know, these are the actual tea lights. They're little candles. You can buy them in two thicknesses, I think, Sharon. These are the smaller of the two.
12-hour burner.
And slightly, well, double the size of that, and they burn for a lot longer, basically. Yeah. So, yeah, she sent us a couple of them.
She sent us three snack bars.
Right, now...
That's snack bars.
Yeah, I'm getting them out, baby, don't worry. I know what they are.
Well, it's you and that.
What do you mean it's me?
It actually looks like a bar of chocolate.
They do look like bars of chocolate. So if we just show you them...
The presentation on them alone is lovely.
Can you see them, look? And I can... Oh, you've been in this one already, look.
That's the one that's actually burning now, which is lovely.
But let's just show you.
I wish you could smell it, actually.
What's it called, Sharon?
Herts, Hogs, Melts and More.
Yeah, and there we go. So they've got little personalised bows on them there. Look, you've got your little logo on there in a single bag.
It's a good job. It's not... I think.
Hello, what's that mean?
Bar of caramel. That's what's in it. That's
this one. It's got monkey farts written on the back, Sharon.
Oh, I haven't smelled
what's that?
This one is... What I've got is linen fresh.
Look, monkey farts. Look, I don't know what that...
I don't know what a monkey farts.
I don't know. I've never seen that.
They're going to have to burn it.
What's that all about then?
And this one is lime, basil and mandarin. And I bet that's not.
I want to try the monkey farts a bit later on, Sharon. I want to see what that's all about.
And I had these... It went on for a long time, this one. And the other one.
What do you do then? Show us what you're doing. I don't know. You've opened one of these already, haven't you? What is actually in here, Sharon?
That is...
Right, so you basically, you bought the bar, she gives us the bar, and it comes in different segments.
I just broke it off like a bar of chocolate, put it on there and it's melted.
And how long has this one lasted so far? You've only used one segment there.
I've literally just put that in.
Right, so that's a new one.
Because now you've got your sense of smell back, where you just smell it. So the other one I put on, which I'll show you in a minute, lasted a good couple of days to smell. And right. I was going to relight it today, but I just sniffed it and I couldn't really smell nothing. Yeah. So I wanted Martin to benefit.
And also, I mean, that's in a liquid form at the moment, obviously. So, but when that goes hard, I would imagine you could just scrape it out as this, like the disc.
Yeah, but I relit it.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying that you could change the flavour or the one
so,
just
yeah.
by taking that one out and then putting a new one in, because that will go. That will solidify once it goes yeah. cold again. You see. So that's the
I've got to open this.
What are they called? Bars. What are they called?
Snack bars.
Snack bars. So that's them. She's also sent us. What are these ones, baby?
Oh my God!
What?
If monkey's farts smell like that.
Show me, sure.
That is delightful.
Oh yeah. Now why don't Barney and not Barney, Dougal and Bleak Merlin's farts smell like that?
That's lovely.
I'll tell you
what. Monkey's farts smell like that. Is it a bit peachy?
I don't know. It's a bit fruity, isn't it? Yeah. Do monkeys eat fruit? Of course they do.
Of course they eat fruit. Yeah. Oh, it's got grapefruit oil in it. I can see.
Oh, I see. This. Right. Okay. So that's them. We've also got. Shout, what's these ones, baby? These little hearts here, what are they called?
That's the first one that I use.
Right, what are these in?
They're not the heart clamshells, are they? Yes, they're heart clamshells, they're in heart, aren't they?
Right, let's show you these.
Stupid me in the clamshell
again,
box.
In a little box like that.
That was lovely.
I mean, the packaging for a home cottage industry business, as you can see, everything's perfect, look.
Yeah, and she's got her lovely stickers as well.
Oh, they're nice.
The little hedgehog. They yeah. are. That was lovely.
As you can see, look, they've actually come in their little containers there.
And I think that was something cotton fresh or something like that.
Oh, that's lovely.
If I go for a candle,
that smells like linen, Sharon.
Yeah, I do look for linen, fresh candles.
Yeah, we like a bit of linen. I love the smell. You know when you get into a fresh bed, cold, fresh bread. So that's them.
I recommend these. Highly recommend.
All these, don't forget, are hand poured. So that's them ones. And
mother and daughter, it's just lovely.
Yeah, mother and daughter, absolutely fantastic. You get a little business card in there as well. You get instructions, simmering. Oh, that's for the simmering crystals.
I haven't done them yet. I might. I'm thinking.
Right, so, right. What do you do with these anyway?
I don't know. I haven't looked.
Can I? Suitable for electric and tea light burners. Add 1 to 2 teaspoons of simmering crystals to your burner. So
God.
You just basically pour them in the top there,
Sharon.
Oh yeah, they're all good, aren't they?
Ooh,
and they're all
goosebumps.
You know, sometimes have you ever gone to that Lush shop, Sharon? We know that, don't we?
It's like, snow
yeah,
fairy.
Yeah, well, yeah, but when you walk in there, it is too overpowering.
Oh, that is beautiful.
The smell gives you a headache, right? These are subtle, which is lovely, like a background smell.
Oh,
Sharon.
This is called fresh.
And then hold on, use an unscented tea light. So colour may fade as long as you blah 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 blah. So all you got to do, yeah, you just use them in the same way by pouring them in there.
Lovely.
So that's them. They do them as well.
Beautiful.
And we've also got these here, which are, what are these ones called, Sharon? We haven't opened these ones yet, have we?
Are they 2 samples of not yet released Christmas scents?
Oh, that must be these ones then. Yeah, look. Let's have a look at those. It should say on the back what they are, shouldn't it?
Cranberry and orange. That's
That'll be
Christmas,
a Christmassy
yeah.
one. That's a single melt you're getting there, folks.
I don't want to open
it. No, don't open it.
It's sealed.
Ginger spice.
Oh.
And cranberry and orange.
Oh,
so again,
yeah.
all Christmas smells.
Oh,
why can't we open it? Because they reseal these packets, yeah?
Well, don't open both.
Why?
I don't know.
They got, look, them, what are they called?
I tell you,
you
what,
crimp them and
Julie
they...
and Vicky Lee, you've got a good sense of smell because you're fantastic.
Open them, up, yeah?
That's the same as that one.
This is cranberry and orange.
Yeah, that's what that one is there.
Go on, have a whiff. Oh. They're so different, a lot of them, they're so different. I ate them when they all smell similar, you know?
You ate them?
Hey?
So did you ever?
I hate it when they all smell similar.
Open that, all right.
Mm.
No, not that one. That's the same.
Look, I'm just showing you. There's a simple rip. Look,
yeah, I've done that.
Yeah, well, then you open it up. Well, I don't know how you've done it, Sharon, but you've done it wrong. No, yeah, look, it's your nails. You should be able to get in there with your nails. Look, it's done. And what's this one called? Ginger spice.
Ginger spice? So is the Spice Girl.
That smells like biscuits. Ginger biscuits is what I think of.
Oh, my God.
We like a ginger biscuit. So
it's just
that's what they've
just show you. There's 2 little hearts in there, so I'd get 2 goes.
Oh, there's two in there.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right. That's the Christmas ones, folks. So that'd be ideal. So they don't just
Christmas.
They give you instructions for use in case you've never used these before as well. So you get a little card in for that.
Oh, there's glitter in them.
You get their business card, as I said to you, and you also get a little simmering crystals instructions if you've never used them before. So what a lovely little set they've sent us there, free of charge, with the burner as well. We have got a burner because we do actually use these as well.
But that's, I haven't got a black burner, so thank you. I've always had, but why? I don't know why.
Yeah. And that comes from
Julie and Vicky Lee, who are Herts, Hog, Melts and more. And Martin, we'll put a link in the description.
In the description. Have they got a website, Sharon?
Yes, they have. And I think they've got one in e-shops.
eBay shop?
Yeah, I've been on Facebook. Can I found them on Facebook.
Oh, right, okay, yeah.
So they're fantastic. Yeah,
the Facebook, what you just said, was their Facebook page.
That's what they are, Hogs,
Herts, and you can also find them on Instagram as well, at Herts Hogs. We do love a scented candle, and we do love these melts. We use these all the time. With dogs and animals in the house, you know, you can get sometimes a background smell. And rather than mask it, they complement it, especially with a monkey fart, maybe.
She has got more smells than this on her side.
Oh, yeah, this is just a sample. Yeah. And talking about the dogs, we just take them out for a walk, haven't we?
Yeah.
The issue we had with Barney... Not Barney. I keep saying Barney, don't I?
I say Bison.
The issue we have with Merlin is that he can't be in company. Well, we need him socialised with other animals, other dogs, basically, because he sees the dog and he goes ape shit, basically, doesn't he? But the way we thought we'd get over that, because for us to get in that sort of situation where we can take him, you've got to, first of all, go to a class where they'll accept that, to walk a dog with them, or even stand on the outside. And we haven't got the time to do that. We're busy people at the end of the day. So what we come up with was... because we got the 65-inch telly in the living room, and he does watch the telly, was to put on there loads of dogs. Dog videos, wasn't it?
A lot of dogs watch telly.
And he started, he reared up at the fireplace, didn't he, trying to jump up there. And we just persevered, we told him down, down, down. And now to this stage where, when they come on, he might get a bit excited at the first one, but then he just turns and looks at them, watches it, and then he falls asleep. So we've got over that little problem of training him to be in the company of other dogs. Because one of the other situations is when we're in the car with him, doesn't he? Yeah. He sees a dog out the window, he's up at the blinking window, blah, blah, blah.
It get through my roof.
But today, yes, you had got a convertible. But today, we took him out, he did see, he reared up once, didn't he?
Yeah.
But then he looks at other dogs, and he hadn't really reared up a lot. So keep associating him on the telly with other dogs, because it's like being in the room, isn't it, really, looking through a window to him, I suppose.
Well, plus, they're in his home, in his space there as well.
We was going to the Saltex show as Retro Restore and Butler's Empire.
That's me, baby.
That was a show for the lawn care community, because on my Retro Restore channel, as you know, we do lawnmower repairs and stuff like that, small engine stuff and all that, and we're sort of in that little community as well. And we was going to go down there to meet a few YouTubers and stuff, but obviously I've had this thing now for 10 days. It looks like I broke the back of it yesterday, because yesterday I got my sense of smell back. And then she woke up yesterday, wasn't it? And this morning. And she felt rough as well. So we've had to abort mission going to that. Not only that, we think it's unfair if we have got a bug or whatever, it's unfair that we go with other people and sort of spread it around, sort of thing. So we're doing a sensible thing. You call that, in a way, we're isolating ourselves, which we have done anyway, away from other people, apart from local family members and all that. So, yeah, we're just being conscientious, and as I say, it was planned for a long time, we had the tickets and everything, so unfortunately I won't be able to see, or we won't be able to see all you YouTubers who was going to turn up there and hopefully meet us and all that, so we will catch you on another occasion maybe, but there are still quite a few YouTubers going, so have a nice time, folks, enjoy yourselves, and don't get too drunk, because we don't drink anyway, so we wouldn't have been drinking anyway, shall we?
No.
Anyway, so there you go, folks, just a little update. Do check out our little... wax melts and candle stuff and all that for Christmas. And if you do feel that you want to try them out, I'm sure they'll do you a little pack like this or whatever. We might do gift packs or whatever. Yeah, just
no, it's not we. See.
Unbelievable.
But I highly recommend. I've given them to my daughter asked. She said, "Oh, let me know, Mum, because she's coming back to the UK soon."
Yeah.
Which is great, but she's not actually coming up. She's coming to Scotland.
Tracey'll be living in Scotland.
But she's in the UK
for 3 years.
Just get in the car and drive the 9 hours.
And where is she living? Where's she going to be living?
Lossiemouth. Lossiemouth for being Lossiemouth.
Which will be somewhere up on where Inverness is, isn't it? Somewhere up there.
Yeah, that's the airport we're going to be using.
Yeah. So apparently it's 9 hours to drive.
About 9 hours on the train as well.
8 hours on the train, something like that. Or we can fly from Luton Airport up there hour and 10 minutes for about 20 quid, something like that.
Yeah, so £22, yeah.
That's the way we'll be doing it anyway. So they're back in the UK, hopefully, to start the Christmas. And you'll probably see us doing a few videos in Scotland.
And thanks for all the people that have been subscribing.
Yes, we've got a few more subscribers now.
Spread the news, spread the love, spread the...
This channel is predominantly a family channel, as you well know. We do get up to some stuff. We do show you other stuff of our family life and all that. And hope you enjoy it.
So and we've updated also our wish list, haven't we? Put little things on there for the dog.
You've asked for it. You've asked for it.
Well, you know.
Stuff for the dog.
People like the dog, so why don't put things on there for the dogs?
The link below for the wish list, folks, is down there. If you want to buy the dog something for their Christmas present. They'll have a chew, by the way. There's a couple of chews on there. And also, I put them antler ones on there. You know, that we was in a pet shop the other day, and he said, dogs love antler horns or whatever, and they're full of protein, apparently. So we put a couple of them on there if you're interested. Anyway, there you go, folks. That's what we got for you today. Keep tuned, because although we're not back to a full strength...
Thumbs up.
I've got loads of work to do. I still haven't finished that fence in the back of the garden. We still got that to do. I've cut the grass yesterday, so that was...
Well done.
I've done that for you, baby, didn't
Thanks,
I?
Baby.
And again, I thought it was going, and yesterday we spent the day on the sofa, and all my sinuses are all sort of clearing out now, and you won't believe the colour of the crap that's coming out of my ooter at the moment, Sharon.
They don't want to know. They've just told me.
Let's just say brown and green.
Why does he do that? Why?
Anyway, thank you very much, folks. We'll see you in the next video. Hey?
Could have been there dinner time.
Shower, who knows?
Don't put this out at dinner time.
No. Well, put it out. Don't matter when you put it out, Shower. That's where they watch it, isn't it?
Well, something for it's tea time now. We see there's nothing on the telly. So we're going, look, there's Butler's Empire. And then he's going to put you off your dinner.
They didn't like that when I cut my toenail. When I had that toenail, which went black.
Oh, yeah.
And I pulled it off, didn't I, and cut it off with a pair of scissors, a black, like a toenail, it was lifted sort of thing, on his little toe. Anyway, that's another story.
Your hair needs a cut, doesn't it?
It does need a cut, baby.
I've just noticed.
Yeah, and it's also a bit grey down the side, you reckon?
I like it.
Talking about hair, I phoned him up yesterday, Wiggy Lee.
We ain't seen him.
No, he's got the pups, he's got the old Tom tits at the moment.
Stay away then.
Yeah, so he's...
not in that bucket.
No, not in his bucket, baby. Not in his bucket. But we will be doing another video with Lee, because I've still got to show you the vehicle that he's bought, which no one knows about yet, apart from one person.
I know. Shall I tell you?
No, don't do that, Shall
I tell you?
One person who's, worked down a local petrol station. If you are watching, you'll know who you are. And apparently Lee's told him. So don't put it in the comment section if you do know. Well, you do know. I know you know. And... yeah, we'll be coming up with that hopefully this week. When he gets better, I was ready to do it this week. So maybe this week you'll see Lee's new vehicle.
Everyone's falling apart, aren't they?
I told Sharon, these viruses...
Time of year.
But this has gone on now for 10 days. Yeah? And it's been from up there, down onto the chest, back up into the head again. I couldn't swallow. You know when you put pressure on your ears and you can pop your ears?
Yeah.
I couldn't do that. I can do that now.
You can talk all right. It never stopped even talking, did it?
Anyway... Thank you very much, folk.
I was just going to see if my little Frank was available. Give people an update on our Frank. Wait a minute.
Oh, where are you going, baby? I can't move, Shower, because this chair just... I nearly fell through this chair just a minute ago. It needs gluing. Oh, look, little baby Frank. Look, little baby Frank. There he is, Shower. Annie, you get the whole Christmas Eve with that jumper on, Shower, and I just realised you look like ABBA.
Oh, my ABBA jumper.
Yeah.
All Friday, people. The ABBA CD will be around.
Yeah, you like that, don't you?
Oh, he even likes it, don't you, Frank?
Look at him, look, little Frank. He loves a bit of ABBA, Shower, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's going to
sleep. How old is he now, Charlotte?
5 weeks on Sunday.
5 weeks?
Well, he was.
Because your mum watches our videos, doesn't she?
Yeah.
So hello to your mum and your nan.
Yeah, say hello to your mum and nanny.
Hi.
Where are you going now, anyway?
Seeing mum.
Seeing your mum. This is Charlotte, by the way. You probably haven't seen a lot of Charlotte. You've only seen her in one video.
I look rough.
Eh?
I look rough.
We all look rough, Charlotte. We're all not well. I've got a cold sore on my lip, Charlotte. Look. Anyway.
Look, you've bored him. He's gone to sleep. Grandad bored you.
Baby Frank.
Should I say Gangi?
Baby Frank. Frank Butler. Frank Charlotte Butler. Unbelievable. Go on in, Shower. We let her go because we've got to finish this video off. Well done, Charlotte. Do you like that smell in here, Charlotte?
Yeah, it's nice.
Where's this little company?
Yeah. Yeah, look, that's the whole row of them there, look.
That one. That one's linen fresh.
Yeah, they smell lovely, don't they?
Mother and daughter.
Home little cottage industry, little home business, so we're going to give them a little push and all that. So
she wanted me to do a review. We've lit them and they smell divine.
They are.
It's a strong smell, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's lovely, isn't it? But it's not overpowering like when you go into Lush. You know that Lush shop?
Headache, yeah.
It's too strong in there and it gives me headache. Yeah. Anyway.
You don't stop going in there though, because Snow Fairy.
I love the Snow Fairy.
I'm wondering, because she said like Lush, will you do a Snow Fairy?
Okay, Baby Frank. Baby Frank's had it as well, folks. He's had the virus, hasn't he? He was one of the first to get it, wasn't he?
No, Jimmy. Jimmy was the first.
Yeah, Jimmy, then little baby Frank, then Charlotte got it, then me, then mummy, or nanny, whatever you want to call yourself.
Nanny and Gangy got it, didn't they?
Yeah. It smells like a knocking shop in here.
How do you know what a knocking shop smells like?
Hey, I've seen them on the telly, Sharon.
If you not smell them.
Don't make me laugh, my lip's cracking. Go on, take baby Frank away. Look at Merlin in protection mode, look.
Are you protecting baby Frank?
You protecting baby Frank, Merlin?
You better.
Hey?
You better.
Look, he's in protection mode, Shell. Go on in, off you go. Have a nice day, Charlotte.
He's about to have another chew. You've been a good boy.
Has he? Can I have a chew, baby? Now give it to him, go on. Good boy.
Good boy.
He is a good boy. Go on, Charlotte, off you go, baby.
So Dougal, because it's not all about Merlin, is it? It's
yeah. Come on, out you go, Merlin.
Come.
Here, look, see? Isn't it funny? We said the dogs are going to stay off of these sofas. Look, they've collared the main sofas now, Sharon, haven't they?
It's all the pillars on, isn't it? He likes it. Oh, doesn't he? That's comfort.
Yeah.
No, you've had yours. All gone.
Merlin? Merlin? You've had yours. Sit down. Sit.
Come.
He's holding these, isn't he, Dougal? Are you holding your chew?
Dummy.
Oh, that's lazy, Dougal. That's lazy.
Do you want Toad in the hole? I said to Jimmy, he's the boss pretender tonight. I said, oh, Toad's in here. Oh, two rubbish dinners in 2 days.
Who said that?
I said, well, what? Today? Yeah, meatballs. I don't like meatballs. I said, right, just have sausages then. Oh, I'll have sausages. But I thought I'd give you the option.
Oh, yeah, I'll
take you on. Toad in the hole, Charlotte.
He didn't even have his Sunday dinner, did he, Charlotte?
That's what we're having. Let her go, Shell, because she's carrying heavy baby.
Yeah, she's chubby now.
Go on, off you go then.
Bye.
See you later.
Bye.
Have a nice day.
I'm getting my shark out now.
Baby shark, baby shark, do 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 do, baby shark, do 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 do.
Didn't we say goodbye?
Hey, yeah, I know.
You said bye like 3 times.
Oh, no,
I know, yeah. See you later, Charlotte.
Bye, Charlotte.
Bye bye, baby.
I think Charlotte goes when she says bye. I've got a headache.
Oh, it's a bit dark here, baby. Oh, come on. Let's go and sit in the front room. I'll edit this video.
No, I'm going to Uber.
Get this up tonight. Well, you do the Ubering. I'll sit on the front room floor. Chairs with Dougal. That cold tour there, look. It's nearly gone. Thanks very much, folks. We are going this time. See you next time. Bye for now. Get a kettle on, baby.